Hi, everyone. We're here with Dave White with the New York Sea Grant, and you have a few things you wanted to talk about this morning, one of them being Brianna's Law.
Absolutely. Many people have heard of Brianna's Law, which is a new boating safety law, and it's named after a young girl who was killed in Long Island. And the exciting thing about this new law on boating safety, it was really developed over the last 4 or 5 years in partnership with the boating industry. So they've really tried to make it palatable and really try to make it something that's really going to be positive for the entire boating industry and boaters. The baseline is everyone who operates a motorboat in New York State is now going to have to take the 8-hour course and get their boater certification card by 2025. It ratchets up by age. So
this was not a thing before?
Well, it was always certain age group, and it was ratcheting up. So we've talked about it before that they put the new law in. It was like May 1996, and then everybody. Now this new law takes that in and says, we're going to move that law farther ahead and by 2025. So probably one of the first cohorts, and I'd have to even go online because the ages are different. So, you know, by the end of next year, you probably need it. Probably by the end of the following year, you need it, and by 2025, I need it because it's all by age.
That's it.
Well, you see, as I always say to people, if you go get your certificate, then you need to go get a boat. So it's that inducement. It's like, go buy a life jacket or win one, and then you have to get a boat to wear it.
So
it's also a great economic driver. So we look forward to hearing what you get next year as your new boat.
Yeah, and I, as her friend, look forward to that as well.
The best kind of boat is a friend's boat.
That's right.
Yeah, that's if I can afford one.
So when you do, and personal watercraft, so anything motorized, you know, I mean, if somebody puts a motor on a canoe, that's a motorized boat, and they would need to have the certificate.
Oh, okay.
I see that it is really exciting. It's really just to raise awareness. Folks can take it online.
That's what I was going to ask, where these courses are offered.
And that was one of the things that the boating industry said is, you know, we want to give people that opportunity to take it online. So if a, you know, if a boater it needs to go take it and they're going to take it online, make sure they go to the New York State Parks website because the certified programs are listed there. And as you know, when these kind of things come out, all of a sudden it's like you'll start to get the emails and the ads.
And they might not be real.
Might not be certain, you know, approved by
the
state.
So how long does it take, the course?
It's an 8-hour course. I always recommend, you know, our friends at the U.S. Coast Guard Auxiliary Power Squadron and those of us that are first certified by the state of New York to teach it, it's a great hands-on class because they'll go through it all. They really talk about
And you probably can get it done in a weekend or something.
Many of them do it either in 2 nights, 2 4-hour things, or they'll do it in just 1 day to get it all done and that kind of thing.
So this is something that everybody needs to have done.
Everybody
correct?
Will need to have it done by 2025. So if you go online, you'll see, you know, what age category am I in, because it ratchets up over the next 5 years by age.
Okay.
The reason I raised it now is for a lot of the folks that are teaching these classes, they do it over the winter. Because, you know, spring and summer, they're
out on the water. You don't want to waste your time taking a course. You want to be already ready.
You want to be ready, and, you know, and that's the problem. Somebody like will, you know, be, you know, like next May, oh, I need my course. And there's nobody out teaching them. They don't have time to go online. Wintertime is a great time to do it. You don't have to take all 8 hours online at one time. You can start
probably come back,
go back and forth. So, you know, I think it's a really great opportunity for folks. You know, moms, dads, grandma, grandpas, aunt and uncles, take it with the kids. You know, take, you know, you can all be on your own computer working together. If you have questions, go through it. So, you know, I'm a real advocate of online if you're working it together. You know, just because that's what you would be doing in a class, getting that help kind of thing. So especially for the younger kids, if moms and dads want to help them, you know, the kids need to take it, but mom and dad can be there to help them.
And you also wanted to talk about life jackets.
We do, because November 1st is the Wear It campaign, as we often talk about, and that's when it kicks in that everybody on board, every boat under 21 feet has to have a life jacket on. As I say, everybody on any boat come that point
they
in time
have them for pets,
cold
too.
Weather. They do. Absolutely.
Oh, right. Yeah, you can get those on Amazon even.
You can, and for pets, you know what the best part of a pet life jacket is? It has a handle on it because you can pull it out of the water. Because otherwise, you're going in the water.
That's right.
Well, that's want to stay safe no matter what.
You do. And you want to have fun. And that, to me, is what all the safety stuff does. It just makes for a great fun day on the water. And Beth is providing us great weather.
For boating still.
For boating opportunity. Get out on the kayak. Paddleboard is getting, you know, a little dicey. The water's starting to get cold. But get out there. Enjoy it. It's going to be a great weekend. Carry it into October.
Weather.
We're going to give Beth all the grief come a few weeks.
So I'll take
now.
This.
Please don't say a few weeks. Yeah. That's a month.
I was waiting to see.
He's just being realistic.
I know.
All right. Thank you, Dave.
All right. Get that boater safety education done. Thank you so much.
Have a great weekend.
We'll be right back.